In a primetime news follow-up now, another King Alarm guard has been fired for misconduct in the recent incident involving a licensed firearm holder at Braemar Estate in St. Andrew. But as it turns out, the guard is seeking to overturn the decision. TVJ's Anthony Lugg reports.
At a press conference last Thursday, King Alarm boss John Azar outlined that disciplinary actions were taken against the three guards found guilty of offense during the incident at the Braemar Estate in St. Andrew. However, only two of the three were found guilty. The guard seen slapping the licensed firearm holder while he was being subdued retained an attorney who requested more time to review the evidence. On Wednesday, Mr. Azar provided an update.
So his disciplinary hearing was held last week Thursday, and ultimately our disciplinary panel found that his conduct was not in keeping with our high standards and our best practices, and his employment was terminated.
The guard has since filed an appeal. That hearing is expected to take place at a later date, which is yet to be set. The incident, which was shared widely on social media, left persons asking why King Alarm waited so long to take action.
In answer to people who are saying, why wasn't action taken quicker, I'll just repeat to say that we don't write the labor codes or the laws, but we have to abide by them. And it may be a good opportunity for me to encourage the powers that be at the PSOG or the Chamber of Commerce to probably look into it. In certain instances, that Labor Code 2010 amendment can be onerous to employers and in some cases expose them to unnecessary liability.
So, did social media influence the company's decision?
That had no bearing at all on what we did. And I'll give you one quick example. There's an incident a couple months ago at a popular Kingston gym where we apprehended some persons who had just been guilty of a shooting, and we came in for a lot of accolades from it. But in the footage that was aired, we saw something that when somebody was subdued on the ground, there was an action by one of our officers which did not keep with our standards. So while there's absolutely no outcry in that instance, we took the necessary internal action against the officer involved because our principles are not swayed by the temperature of social media.
Anthony Lugg, TVJ News.